Nice weather, though. Some interesting stuff I read today. I guess the first thing was kind of related to like yesterday with that drone delivery stuff. Well, how about actually seeing what it looks like? This one says, the Wind Racer Ultra UAV drone to be used to transport medical supplies to support the response to COVID-19 at St. Mary's Hospital. Wind Racer is working with Solent Transport to trial an innovative and fast UAV drone transportation service as a result of the COVID-19. The aim is to transport medical supplies and equipment to St. Mary's Hospital, Isle of Wight, from the Southampton General Hospital via the Solent Airport in only 20 minutes. Now, what this was kind of interesting is how, you remember with the comments yesterday, people are saying, oh, these things will crash in the wind and the rain and all that stuff, because even for myself, when you say drones nowadays, we're thinking more like prosumer types of drones, like maybe something from DJI. But then look at this stuff, man. This one looks like almost like a full-fledged airplane, isn't it? So you can use this, I guess, they say 20 minutes, and yeah. To me, I wouldn't be able to tell the difference if I saw it just from a distance there. So would you feel more secure if you saw a drone like this transporting something of, I guess, importance? Like, let's just say those kidneys, for example, although it looks a little too big to be as flexible and quick, like to launch up in the air immediately. I don't think you'll be seeing this in urban food drone delivery areas, though, that's for sure. I guess another interesting thing is, with all this pandemic and stuff like that, people are saying, wear masks, and apparently there are a lot of people not wearing them properly to the point where it's kind of, I guess, pointless. But how about someone actually getting into like a really bad accident and all that because of it? I mean, check this out. Apparently there was a driver who's inside the car wearing an N95 mask, and it says here, they believe the excessive wearing of the N95 mask was a contributing factor to this accident. While we don't know this with 100% certainty, we do know that the driver had been wearing an N95 mask inside the vehicle for several hours until ultimately passed out while operating the vehicle. And yeah, you can see the picture of the car accident itself, so I think from what I gather, like it says here, it's due to the lack of oxygen with the guy wearing a mask inside the car. It says the crash is believed to have resulted from the driver wearing an N95 mask for several hours and subsequently passing out behind the wheel due to insufficient oxygen intake, excessive carbon dioxide intake. Motorists and public alike are reminded that while masks should be used in public settings to help prevent the spread of COVID-19, they are not necessary outdoors when social distancing can be maintained, and especially not necessary when driving a vehicle with no additional occupants. I do wonder about that actually. Even when I walk by, you see everyone in their cars with their mask. Aren't you technically protected inside there, like from everyone else as well, if that's what you're afraid of, like with the virus? Usually when it comes to stuff like this too, it's like everyone's a doctor and an expert when you read online, right? It's just interesting reading like the debates. Like this person here says the person is a physician, and they're saying it's positively useless, inappropriate to wear a mask by yourself driving your car for several reasons. But then some people say you have to wear it because you're technically not supposed to touch your mask, like take it off and on, otherwise you'll get it infected. So who's right in that case? He got spooked by the dog. Random. All right. See you guys later.